Hi, welcome to our Pharma Topics channel, which aims at simplifying the pharmacy subjects and allied health sciences subjects. Our topic of discussion is very important, the drugs used in acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, or HIV, that is human immunovirus. Basically, HIV is of two types, HIV-1 and HIV-2. Throughout the globe, HIV-1 is more prevalent. In the African countries, HIV-2 is more prevalent. Throughout the worldwide, around approximately 37 million people are infected with AIDS. In India, the scenario is out of the 135 million population, 2.1 million are infected with the HIV. The National AIDS Control Program was launched in 1992, and in 2004, National AIDS Control Organization was framed. Now those who are identified with HIV or AIDS, they are treated with antiretroviral drugs, and in India it is of free of cost. So let us see the virus first, how it appears. The virus has different important parts in it. One is the HIV envelope. And it has envelope protein called HIV glycoproteins, and the inside the envelope it has a HIV capsid, and it carries an RNA. It is a retrovirus. It carries the RNA, and more importantly, it contains the enzymes. The enzymes are reverse transcriptase, integrase, and protease. In HIV, two things are very important: CD4 cells and the viral load or the viral titer of HIV. Before HIV infection, the CD4 cells count is around 500 to 1200 cells per microliter. When the HIV gets infected, in case of acute infection, the HIV titer increases and the CD4 cells are not affected much at the earlier stages. As the disease progresses, as chronic HIV infection, in the prolonging years, the CD4 count gradually decreases, whereas the HIV titer increases gradually. It reaches a stage where the CD4 cells become less than 200 cells per microliter. And that condition is called as acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So what is the seriousness of this when the CD4 cells are reduced? Let us see that. When the CD4 cells reduce below 200 cells per mm or per microliter, it leads to several opportunistic infections. The opportunistic infections are HIV-related encephalopathy, which affects the brain, cytomegalovirus retinitis, which affects the eyes, causes loss of vision, pneumocystitis jirovecii, pneumonia, which affects the lungs, and chronic intestinal cryptosporidiosis, which affects the intestine, and invasive cervical cancer. All these things happen after few years of infection. Let us see the life cycle of HIV and the classification of antiretroviral drugs. The first step is the virus binds or fuses with the CD4 cells with the help of the glycoproteins. Then with the help of the envelope opens, it releases its RNA and the enzymes along with it. One of the important enzyme is reverse transcriptase. With the help of reverse transcriptase, the released RNA is integrated with the first the released RNA gets converted to DNA, and that DNA gets integrated with the host DNA or the CD4 cell DNA with the help of the enzyme integrase. The next step is it starts replication of forming its proteins and the RNA out of it. The next, is the assembly of the viral RNA and the viral proteins, and that becomes encapsulated inside the capsid. The next step is budding of the new virions. Several new virions release and they infect the other CD4 cells. So let us see the drugs, important drugs in this, that is antiretroviral drugs. The first one is viral fusion inhibitors such as enfuvirtide and maraviroc, which are fusion inhibitors. They cause inhibition of the fusion of the virus to the CD4 cells. The next is nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors or non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, which block the reverse transcription, that is conversion of RNA, viral RNA to viral DNA. The next is integrase inhibitors. When the DNA, viral DNA is formed, it has to get attached or integrated to the host DNA or the CD4 DNA. That step is blocked by the integrase inhibitors. The more important drugs are protease inhibitors. The protease inhibitors cause the inhibition of development of the polypeptides to functional proteins, and also viral budding is inhibited by the protease inhibitors. So this is the classification of drugs used in HIV or AIDS. Let us see the drugs individually. First one is a viral fusion inhibitors. So the HIV viral envelope gets fused with the host CD4 cells, which releases its contents, that is the HIV RNA, HIV enzymes to the, and that gets released from the CD4 cell membrane. So the viral fusion inhibitors block the viral fusion protein GP41 with a co-receptor CXCR4. And the next one is there is a tropic virus which gets converted in few days of treatment of ART therapy with the new protein called GP120 with a co-receptor called CCR5. The drugs used to address this is enfuvirtide. It addresses CXCR4 tropism. The next drug is maraviroc. It is suitable only for patients who express CCR5 co-receptor. It is not effective in CXCR4 co-receptors. And dual tropic viruses are also possible where the patient expresses both GP120 and GP41. The fusion inhibitors are the best class of drugs for newer infections. The next is a viral integrase inhibitors. When the viral DNA is formed from the reverse transcriptase, it has to integrate with the host DNA or the CD4 cell DNA. This step is blocked by the integrase inhibitors, which block the insertion of HIV DNA into the CD4 cell DNA. And the important drugs in this classification are raltegravir and dolutegravir. You remember these drugs with the code TEGRA, that means VIR is viral, GRA is integrase, TEGRA is integrase. The only thing you have to remember these drugs, with these drugs, is the absorption is reduced by calcium and magnesium ions, that is with the antacids. It gets the reduced absorption. Let us see about the very important class of drugs, nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors and non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. So the reverse transcription is an important step where the viral RNA is transcripted with reverse transcriptase, gets converted to HIV DNA that gets integrated with the CD4 DNA or the host DNA. So this step is blocked by the reverse transcriptase inhibitors, which block the conversion of HIV RNA to the HIV DNA. There are two classifications. One is nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. All these things are false nucleotides. They block the chain elongation and they need phosphorylation for activation. There is only one drug which is a nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor, tenofovir, which does not need phosphorylation. And the non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors bind to reverse transcriptase enzyme at a distinct site. They does not need phosphorylation. Let us see about these drugs in detail. So the nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors are zidovudine. It is a thymidine analog. The adverse effects are anemia, neutropenia, and gastrointestinal disturbances. The next drug is didanoside. It is an adenine analog. The most important adverse effects are peripheral neuropathy. You can remember this as stocking and glove neuropathy. That means when we put gloves, that portion, when we put socks, that portion has peripheral neuropathy. That is called stocking and glove neuropathy. It is numbness and tingling in the portion of the, such as gloves, where we put the gloves and where we put the socks. It causes rarely pancreatitis. The next drug is stavudine. It is a thymidine analog. The most important adverse effect is disturbance of the lipids, that is lipodystrophy, lactic acidosis, and peripheral neuropathy. And the other drug is lamivudine. It has mild adverse effects, so preferable for combination therapy. Abacavir is a guanosine analog. The most important adverse effect is hypersensitivity. When hypersensitivity occurs, the drug has to be stopped. The next drug is emtricitabine. It is a fluorinated cytidine analog. It is least toxic, so preferable for combinations. The only one drug which is a nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor is tenofovir. It causes renal toxicity, so it is essential to monitor the renal function while on tenofovir therapy. The next is non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Three drugs are available. One is nevirapine. It is metabolized by CYP3A4. So many drug interactions are possible with CYP3A4 inducers and inhibitors. The adverse effects are rashes. It causes potential hepatotoxicity. So the liver function has to be monitored. The next drug is efavirenz. It is metabolized by CYP2D6. It has a longer biological half-life and low hepatotoxicity. The adverse effects are neuropsychiatric symptoms, which actually reduces over the time. Both nevirapine and efavirenz have cross resistance. That means when nevirapine has become resistant, it shows resistance to efavirenz also, and vice versa. The next drug is ertavirine. It is used for NNRTA resistant strains for nevirapine and efavirenz. Let us see about protease inhibitors. The protease is an important enzyme which causes the maturity of the immature HIV virus, that is development of the precursor proteins to functional proteins, and viral packaging and budding is in the hands of protease enzyme. So this step is blocked by the protease inhibitors. So they block the new HIV virus becoming mature HIV virus so that they can infect the other CD4 cells. Let us see about the protease inhibitors, which are very important antiretroviral drugs. They do not require intracellular activation by phosphorylation. They have difference in their bioavailability. Ritonavir has a bioavailability of 65%. Nilfenavir has 20% and saquinavir has 15% approximate bioavailability. All these drugs are metabolized by CYP3A4 inhibitors, but nilfenavir is metabolized by CYP2C19. Co-prescription with the CYP3A4 inhibitors or inducers has numerous drug interactions. The other important thing about protease inhibitors are they have a large tablet load. That is, they have to patients have to take 6 to 8 tablets per day. Ritonavir is a potent CYP3A4 inhibitor. It is actually it is used as a booster drug. So when it is combined with other drugs, it reduces the dose of the co-administered drugs. The other drug which is used for booster therapy, which is a new drug, is cobicistat, which is very similar to ritonavir. The adverse effects of protease inhibitors are most importantly lipodystrophy. You can see in the diagram, it is like a buffalo hump. They have abdominal obesity and wasting of the face and the limbs. The other adverse effects are disturbance of the lipid levels, dyslipidemia, and gastrointestinal disturbances. Indinavir crystallizes in urine and also causes hyperbilirubinemia. Atazanavir causes gastrointestinal disturbance, dyslipidemia, and jaundice. Saquinavir also causes phototoxicity. Lopinavir may cause ECG abnormalities. The treatment guidelines as per WHO or NACO guidelines. So when to start the therapy? When the CD4 count reduces below 500 cells per microliter, then they have to start with the ART therapy. Usually the therapy is called heart therapy, highly active antiretroviral therapy. It is a triple drug regimen. The treatment is for lifelong. The treatment for the treatment naive patients, that is new patients, 2 NNRTI plus 1 NNRTI or the integrase inhibitors are given. Suppose if the integrase inhibitors the patient may not afford, they may go for 2 NRTI plus 1 NNRTI. In the developed countries, they give 2 NRTI plus integrase inhibitors. If they have metabolic disorders also, they go for integrase inhibitors. The combination of three drug regimen, 2 NRTI plus protease inhibitors, they are reserved for advanced cases of high viral load or earlier treatment failure cases. At the start of the therapy with ARTs, it causes immune reconstitution inflammatory syndrome called IRIS. It is due to the marked inflammatory reactions. For pregnancy, breastfeeding and delivery patients with AIDS, you remember the drug names Zelent, that is zidovudine, emtricitabine, lamivudine, efavirenz, nevirapine and tenofovir. These are the safer drugs. So what is the aim of the ART therapy? The aim of the therapy is the optimal treatment means HIV RNA should become undetectable, that is less than 50 copies per microliter from an imaginary number of, that is 1 lakh copies to less than 50 copies per microliter within 6 months, and restoration of CD4 count to near normal within 6 months of therapy. That is, it has to improve and the viral load has to decrease. So the therapy will look like this. At the start of the therapy, it gradually decreases to undetectable levels, and when it rises after few months or few years after the treatment with a particular regimen, if it increases, it means it is drug resistance. Then the regimen has to be changed. So the resistant drug has to be identified and it has to be replaced. Let us see the HIV treatment regimens. For the first line drugs are you remember as TEL and TEE, that is tenofovir, emtricitabine and efavirenz. Combination is given. The alternate regimen is ZIL, ZLN, TEN, TLN, TED or TLD. That is a triple drug regimens: zidovudine, emtricitabine, lamivudine, nevirapine and dolutegravir. If the first line drugs fail, then they go for other triple drug regimens. The first one is tenofovir with atazanavir. Second is dolutegravir and atazanavir, and third, if it fails, then they go for tenofovir with zidovudin and or lamivudin. D is didanoside and A is abacavir. The protease inhibitors, you just remember asin, that is atazanavir, saquinavir, indinavir and nelfinavir. L you remember as lopinavir. All these combinations are along with ritonavir, that is the slash R. In case of pre-exposure prophylaxis, when a person is with a nearby with a carrier, then it is called pre-exposure prophylaxis. Then they have to take precautions. They will be put on tenofovir with emtricitabine therapy. Post-exposure prophylaxis. If they have, they are exposed to the blood or the secretions or in sexual contact, then it is called post-exposure prophylaxis. For adults, it is given for, the treatment is given for 4 weeks. Preferred regimen is tenofovir with emtricitabine along with abacavir, that is atazanavir with ritonavir or lopinavir with ritonavir. Alternatively, they may add the integrase inhibitors. The post-exposure prophylaxis should be given within 1 to 2 hours of exposure and should not be given beyond 72 hours because it is of no use. The post-exposure prophylaxis in case of children, that is less than 10 years, the preferred one is zidovudin plus lamivudin. The alternate treatment is abacavir plus lamivudin or tenofovir plus lamivudin or emtricitabine. Alternatively, they may give integrase inhibitors also. In case of pregnancy or breastfeeding woman or perinatal, that is during delivery, the HIV may get infect the fetus also. So the preferred regimen is TEL, that is tenofovir, emtricitabine and lamivudin. And nevirapine syrup has to be given to the neonates for 6 weeks. And it is advised if the HIV RNA copies are more than 1000 per microliter, then cesarean is advisable. For needle stick injuries, the preferred regimen is tenofovir, emtricitabine and raltegravir for 28 days. So this nutshell information of all the HIV, anti-HIV drugs or antiretroviral drugs. I hope it will be useful for all the students. Thank you for listening. Happy learning. Kindly share this to your friends. Kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel for more, putting more videos and encourage us. Thank you.